you know, acknowledges the traditional owners of the land we are on today. I'm Vi Emu and I'm excited to be learning with you. In our top story, Nick Wombat takes us to check out some interesting looking tools used by traditional Aboriginal people. Let's take a look.
Thanks, Vi. I'm here with Dion Dingo, who's been sharing his collection of traditional Aboriginal tools. Dion, you have a very impressive collection here.
Thank you, Nick. I've been collecting these tools for many years, and I love teaching people about them.
There are a lot of things here. Did all Aboriginal people use the same tools?
Every mob had implements such as knives, scrapers, axe heads, spears, various vessels for eating and drinking, and digging sticks. But tools and implements varied depending on where people lived because of the materials available. For example, coastal people used fishbone to tip their weapons, while people living inland used stone tips. Also, some people didn't have use for some tools. For instance, people who didn't live near water had no need for fishing tools.
That makes sense. There's a few things here that I wouldn't consider to be tools. Like those baskets. Why are they in the collection?
Haha, many people are confused by the inclusion of the baskets, but I have included them and everything here because these are the tools that traditional Aboriginal people used in everyday life. Baskets were important tools because they carried personal items and foods that were needed by the Aboriginal people to live. The baskets were weaved using grasses and reeds that were carefully selected. Weaving took a lot of time and skill, and woven items were prized. Today, weaving is seen as an art form. Other woven tools include eel traps, nets, and dilly bags. Dilly bags are woven bags with strings attached so they could be worn around the neck. Dilly bags were used to collect and carry food and other small items.
So Aboriginal people used the materials around them to make the tools and implements they needed?
That's right. Aboriginal people were very good at using natural resources to make the things they needed. Woven implements were made from local grasses and weeds, so the type of material differed from area to area depending on what was available. Stone was also a popular choice for implements. Stone tools were used for many things, including making other tools, collecting and preparing food, chopping wood, and preparing animal skins. Because of the way they used stone, Aboriginal people were the first to introduce ground edges on cutting tools to grind seeds.
Wow, I didn't know that Aboriginal people were leaders in stone technology. How do we know they were the first people to use this technology?
Yes, we can learn a lot from the methods used by traditional Aboriginal people. Because of the properties of stone, stone tools have survived well, and we have been able to examine them and learned a lot about how Aboriginal people used stones and how they were leaders in stone technology.
What kind of things were made from stone?
Stones were used to crush and grind things like seeds, and could be used like a hammer. They could also be used to sharpen tools, as well as be made into tools like stone axes, spearheads, and cutting tools. In some areas, stones were used to make fish traps. These were used where water levels rose and fell, trapping fish in areas enclosed by stones when water levels dropped.
Stone sounds very versatile. I can see a lot of wooden tools here. Can you tell us about them?
Yes, there were lots of wooden tools. Wood was used a lot, potentially even more than stone. Wood was used to make things like spears, woomeras, nulla nullas, boomerangs, clubs, and canoes. However, wood isn't as hard wearing as stone and the implements have perished over time, so we have less examples to study.
I see. And what were the wooden implements used for?
Wooden tools were used for lots of things. Spears were used for hunting and fighting. Nulla nullas and clubs were also used as weapons. Boomerangs, koolamons, and other wooden vessels were used in hunting and gathering. Message sticks were also made from wood. These were an important communication tool, used to communicate between different language groups.
Well, Dion, thanks for talking to me about all these tools today. I'm going to check some of these things out a bit more closely. Back to you in the studio, Vi.
Thanks, Nick. And thank you, Dion Dingo. You have taught us a lot today. It's amazing how far back some of the tools and techniques we use today can be traced. Traditional Aboriginal people certainly were good at using natural resources. Thanks for joining me today. I look forward to learning with you again soon.